Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 39 of Direwolf20's Let's Play series. I've got two episodes before I have another world download for you guys, don't I? That sounds about right. I think I've come up with a plan for what I want to get completed before I give you guys that world download. There's a few things that I might want to change up or add. One of those, I think, is going to be related to power. So currently, we've got a really good system of oil gen. This thing has been running my base for weeks now, and I've had no problems with it, to the point where it actually does a really good job of filling up our internal capacitors. It's awesome. Using a lot of RF right now. What's running at the moment that's killing RF so fast? 2,477, that seems like a lot. I don't know, it just seems like a lot of RF. Oh, you know what it is? Well, I mean, it shouldn't be that much over here. Yeah, this is only using 616. My quarry's not running. What's using so much power? Beats me. I hear Enderman. Ah, my Enderman spawner's running. That's why. Haha. Yes. I was in there checking stuff out. Come here, Enderman. I got a little job for you. Give me some heads. Goodness, Enderman, you're loud. They're really not friendly, are they? Alright, two more to go. Hopefully I'll get some heads from this. Getting some nice upgrades from fighting monsters, though. And yes, Endermen are monsters. Kind of curious what upgrades I got here. Wow, I got a lot. Fear Strike, Experienced, Tough Skin. Nice. We're already up to 90 upgrade points. But we've got 300, so that's cool. And we got 3 Enderman heads, which is even cooler. So there's a couple things I wouldn't mind getting for myself, just to make my life easier. I would like... It's something I've been meaning to get for a little while now, and it's about time we actually get it. I would like, from Ender.io, the wireless charger. This is a nice little gadget. I just need an Enderman head, 2 Solarium, and a Vibrant Ally. So, 2 Solarium, an Enderman head, Vibrant Alloy. We'll get that going. And the other thing we're going to need is an Octadec capacitor. And some electrical steel. That's going to take a minute to cook up. And while that runs, I want to explain to you guys what my power issues are. So right now, we're doing pretty good. We're getting about 4,000 RF a tick from all these machines. It just stopped, so it might even be a little bit higher. Because these are 350 each, and I've got about 9 of them. So, yeah, not bad. We're using about 1,000 RF a tick. But if I were to activate something like my quarry, does a great job of collecting lots and lots of materials for us, all of a sudden we're using a lot more power. Yeah, definitely killing it. So the quarry's actually not doing too bad. It's pretty good, actually. I thought the quarry used a little bit more power than that. But if I also want to activate my Enderman spawner, and soon I'm going to want to get... I'm probably getting close to the point where I'd like to do some wither killing, and if I want that, I'm gonna have to get a wither spawner, and that would be rough. Yeah, that's gonna be a rough time. So in order to manage to power some of the more advanced stuff, I think we need to get more advanced power gen. One of the mods I want to take a look at is a mod I haven't played with in a while. Oh, what are you flickering? Don't tell me you're flickering over here, buddy. You are flickering. What is going on? Am I not transferring power fast enough? That could be the case. You know what? Maybe my quarry would be faster if I had the appropriate amount of power transfer going on. Let's turn you off for a minute. Man, we can't power our base. That struggles. What do we got going on here? What is happening? You are doing a decent amount of power loss at the moment. With this thing off. You know what it is? I think it's because I did turn this off, didn't I? Yeah, you're off. Oh, that's right. The builder that's in the deep dark takes a moment to recharge itself. It's probably got an internal capacitor it needs to refill. Because this is off, but still. It's not running. Man, what is killing my power so much? I am not even sure, to be honest with you. $2,820 RF a tick. Something's really killing it. I mean, this thing's crafting, but it's not using that much power. It might be going to the deep dark. That's the only thing I can think of. Are you done flickering at the moment? You are. So it was probably the internal capacitor of the deep dark. So what I'm going to say is that our power network right now, insufficient. Because remember, these wires can only handle about 5,120 RF a tick. I think when we turn on that thing, we're definitely hurting more. So yeah, now we're getting a net gain. Cool. So I'd like to upgrade my power production system. I think that would be a good time. So if I could have everything a little bit more efficient, that would be nice. Out of curiosity, what's involved in making... This is the advanced. Extreme just takes an advanced and two empowered diamantine crystals. This can do 100,000 RF a tick, which isn't bad. It might be cool. We might want to investigate doing that. We've currently got advanced upstairs. So they can do, I want to say, like 10,000 RF a tick. Which isn't a lot, but it's not a small amount either. All right, let's get these guys... Oh, another upgrade. Sweet. So many upgrades. So when this thing runs, we lose power, right? All of a sudden, we're crushing our production of power. So we're probably getting power through our laser system right now, but we're losing a lot of power. Yeah, see? Send receive buffer's empty. This thing starts flickering. I think one of the things we'll want to do first is get an upgraded power line in here. So this guy has the capability of outputting 25,000 RF a tick, but the wires can only do 5,000. So if we got the next tier of energy conduit, we'd probably be in better shape. So hopefully you're done flickering down there. Did you guys finish making that octadict capacitor for me? Probably not. Cool. We should have gotten our two solarium. We've got our steel going, 10. And I wanted to get the vibrant. Couple silicon. What else is needed for this thing? I think that's it. So you go into the slice and splice. Nice. Beautiful. And we're making steel over there. Wireless. Charger time. Cool. This guy can go under the floor. He has a decent range. Not crazy, but decent. We'll put him right here. Boom. Check out this. Staff of Traveling just filled up. As will my Ender, as will pretty much anything else in my inventory that needs RF, including the battery. So the wireless charger will fill up my battery for me. The battery I can use while I'm out in the field, right? But other things that don't get filled up by the battery, like the Ender IO items, they will be filled up by that wireless charger. Pretty cool, right? I'm leaving this grass block here as a reminder that the Endermen were in my basement. Endermen. All right, next up, let's get... So notice every time I use my staff, it refills automatically. Yeah, that's awesome. Let's get some more conduits going. So conduits, I want to teach you how to make these guys. So these are expensive, not going to lie. But they're not too expensive. So let's get like a stack of them. That shouldn't be too bad. And we'll be back in a minute when the crafting's done. All right, guys, we're back. So, did a little bit of crafting and some work off camera. You guys already saw me upgrade my energy conduits from low to mid tier, so I just kind of did that all off camera. I figured you wouldn't complain. You didn't want to watch me place all those blocks, did you? I thought not. So, now I just made myself another 25 million RF capacitor, which is cool. It's charging in my inventory because that's what happens. I'm gonna replace this dude with this dude. Now, are you gonna be able to get power, or do I have to reconnect my phantom face guy? What's this guy say over here? Vibrant capacitor bank. Okay, cool. So it is connected. He's losing power at the moment, but that's okay. Are you guys giving him power? He is. Nice. Okay, cool. So see, he's already transferring power a lot faster. You probably need some filling up. Yes, that is exactly what's happening. So this guy's getting filled up. This guy is now getting filled up. And everything's working. The only difference is now that we have a 25,000 RF capacitor over here instead of... or 25 million instead of 5 million, right? And 25,000 output input instead of 5. So that's actually really cool. The other thing I was going to make real quick, if I can, I taught my system how to make some extreme laser relays. A little bit of a decent number of resources, but I think will be cool. The only problem, and I still haven't figured out a solution to this, is how to deal with this system if we like get the wrong items going at the wrong time. You know what I mean? I have to figure that out, kind of. But we're definitely going to need some empowered things going on. And we've got many, like, laser things. So yeah, that's exactly what I'm talking about. Crafting multiple things like that at once is painful. And it's causing me trouble. And I have to figure out what I'm going to do about that. Wrong one. I had to fix this, and I just don't know how. I will figure out a solution. And I purposely showed this on camera to remind you guys that I haven't figured out how to fix this yet. Goodness, we have a lot of things going on here. Definitely need to figure out a solution to this issue that I've got. All right, let me come back in a minute so that I can get this all done. All right, so let's get things running again. So you are now going to be connected to... You probably don't need to be extreme, right? Because... We'll see if we get to a point where this thing needs more than 10,000 RF a tick. And this guy can still connect to these at the speed that he has 1,000 RF a tick going over this way. But this is the one that we probably want to hook up to the extreme system. So let's put extreme here. You still can't reach over to here, can you? It would be so cool if he could. Let's do this to here. And this... to here. Cool. Now this guy should be able to accept a large amount of RF, like a really large amount. So that's cool. So let's go turn on our quarry again. And hopefully this guy won't lose power now. Because what's going to happen is this thing's going to be losing RF at a pretty significant rate. 10,000 RF a tech being lost here. So yeah, there you go, right? That's what I was expecting to see. Keep in mind we're producing 4,000 RF a tech. And we're losing 10, so we're really losing a lot. But this thing's doing a great job of transferring his power over, and I'm very proud of him. So we'll turn this back off. This guy didn't flicker. So pretty much we're at a point now where it's no longer the transferring of power that's a problem, it's the generation of power that is a problem. So I'd like to get into deep resonance. All right, guys, I'm thinking about how I want to rearrange this power room a little bit. What I'm thinking I'd like to do is up here is where I've been doing a lot of the crafting of stuff. So like I've got my fermenting barrels and stuff, right? And this thing's doing a fine job. Nice. Very proud of you. Everything's working beautifully. Down here, I'd like to move my oil generators so that downstairs is where a lot of the power generation occurs. Now this basement is really ugly. I need to purdy it up at some point. I feel like I need to like rearrange a few things. I don't know. I haven't figured out what I want to do. But in here is where I'm going to have my deep resonance power generator. This 5x5 room that I've built should be sufficient in size to do the reactor stuff that we need to do. So what I'm thinking is I could have like here and where these conduits are. So this will be my 3x3. That's what I currently have, right? Yes, of oil generators. Right. So what I've done to facilitate this is disconnected this oil thingy here. So he should no longer be, well, he can have one more bucket's worth. So we're producing a lot of oil and everything. I used up a lot of oil to fill up this thing. So we're actually doing pretty good now. It's filling back up. We're burning through oil. I wanted to not waste all the oil that was inside the conduits here. So I disconnected this and I'm letting all this oil burn through. So I'll move my oil generators to here. I'm going to feed them into this capacitor, which is then going to go and get hooked up to this energy phase. And then I'll feed the energy from this guy into the same capacitor. And then we're going to do stuff to turn on the reactors as needed. So we'll be back in a minute once this oil is all cleared out. All right, we've almost burned through the backlog of oil that I've gotten here. I had to turn my quarry on a bit. This actually produces a lot of power, this empowered oil stuff. It's pretty awesome. So I really like the Actual Editions oil generator. It's just, in my opinion, it's a lot of fun to build this like complex automation setup to get this oil going, and it's worthwhile. It's not like a crazy large amount of power, but it's enough to make it worth doing, which is cool. Like sometimes mods get into this weird trap where it's like really hard to set up, and then once you have it set up, it's really not worth it. And then other mods have stuff where it's like really easy to set up and it's like a silly large amount of power, right? I really like this one because it's actually a decent amount of effort to get up and running. And then once you do, it's fulfilling because, hey, look, we got a good amount of power out of it. It's not a crazy amount, but it's a good amount. So what we're going to do is clear all this stuff out of here. And yes, I'm using my drill to break all these conduits. At this point, it doesn't matter. It doesn't need to be done. But you're going to be cleared out. So right now, we're not actually powering stuff. But we have 50 million RF of backlog, right? We've got this guy. And we've got this guy. So between these two, we should be good for a little bit. So not super worried about not having enough power while I get this moved and relocated, right? So we're going to move this down here. And what we're going to wind up having cool is we will have you and you. Let's put these back here. Really got to make this look a little bit nicer at some point. Okay. And then this, I think I'm going to run underground to here. And we might need a few more conduits. Luckily, I can reach my remote base from here. So I'm going to want a few of those, I'm going to want a few of these, and I'm going to want some of this. And you're going to be set to always accept power. So you're going to be cool. We're going to put our oil generators here. Now here's a cool trick with oil generators. It's actually a recent addition to Actually Editions. It's new. I don't know why you have a different... Oh, you've got a little bit of oil in you. That's why. So this is kind of new. The feature to disable the generators from running when receiving a redstone signal was added. So we can now give these oil generators a redstone signal, and that will stop them from running whenever they're receiving a redstone signal. So I probably should have done this before I put stuff back here, but it's all good. Let's put this in here, right? So we'll hook up some of these. Now, there's one little catch to this. I don't understand the mechanics of Minecraft as it relates to things, but some blocks tell Minecraft that they can receive a redstone signal and some blocks don't, and these generators don't really say I can receive a redstone signal. So we actually have to go in here and make sure that there's a connection set. It's really actually kind of tricky. Let's see. So what we want to do is say in out. Yes, that's what we want. Cool. So we go to the redstone tab and say in out. Go to the redstone tab and say in out. So this kind of forces it to have a connection there. Redstone tab in out. Redstone tab in out. And you can see that little connection occurring now. So now, there we go. All of them have a connection. Cool. So that, check this out. What I'm going to do is, so we're going to want a couple things. First off, I want to move my power monitor down here. So we're going to move this. You can move down here. We'll connect this guy. Cool. That looks good. You're going to be set to always accept power. And then I'm going to have a connection here like that. So this guy, we're going to configure the top to be output so that he's always sending power. Boom, and he just did. So he transferred all his power into this guy by way of Phantom Energy Face. Cool. I could set the input here on the bottom. That's fine. It doesn't really matter, I don't think, but it's all good. So that's set up now. So the next thing we're going to want to do is monitor the power. So these guys, I don't know if I want that block there. Should really make this place look a little bit nicer. I really should. So I want to make sure that the reading occurs down here, I think. What I'm going to need is a redstone torch, and I'll tell you why in a sec. Okay. It's going to act as a not gate for me, because here's the deal. I'm going to have a power monitor here. Boom. And we're going to configure him that when you're less than 75%, you're going to emit a redstone signal. And when you're greater than 90, you're going to turn it off. These guys can't be configured to run when they're receiving a redstone signal. They're only configured to run when they're not receiving a redstone signal. And if you give it redstone, it'll stop running. So it's basically the opposite of what this does. And we can't tell this guy to do its opposite. So we basically have to do a not gate, which is what we're going to do. So we're going to have, I'll put this here, and here, and here. So you should be emitting a signal right now. You are. I was hoping that that would turn off the redstone signal here, but it's not. Would you? You wouldn't turn it off? No. So let's move it down one more. You're emitting a redstone signal, yes. Yes. Cool. And then we can have our insulated conduits here. Okay. So check this out. I'm going to remove this guy. And the last component of this will be to have these cables going here. I didn't mean to do that, but that's okay. It'll be fine. Cool. Nice. Now you guys are getting empowered oil, but you're not running because there's a redstone signal at the moment because I removed that block, right? So if we went down here, so this redstone torch is keeping the insulated redstone conduits lit, which is preventing the generators from running. Okay, I'm going to make sure we have a decent backlog of oil in these things for a moment. Shouldn't take too long to fill this thing up. He's probably filling up his conduits behind the wall, which is cool. So now that we've backfilled this empowered oil, which is cool, and I want to make sure that you're set to extract always active, just so there's no like oil flowing in and out of this collector thingy. I don't think it's necessary, but it never hurts. So now, when I place down this thing, he's going to turn off the signal and check out what's going to happen. All of a sudden, we're generating power. And the power is going into here. And that is feeding power into here. Cool. Nice. 2,000-ish RF a tick. I would expect to be getting a little bit more. These guys are all running, correct? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, they're all running. Might just be power being distributed somewhere, like power being used at some point. Doesn't seem like quite as much as I would expect. Keep an eye on it for a minute. See, down here we're generating 3150, which is about how much I would expect. So hook this guy back up. Cool. So that's about right, probably. I would say I'm probably using about 1,000 RF a tick. This is why we need more power. All right, so now that we've got this moved and set up, let's go ahead and get into deep resonance. Right, so what I'm going to do is build a system that's going to be up here-ish. What's also nice about this is now I have a way to run conduits up there. That'll be kind of cool. Yeah, this is definitely nice. So the plan is that I will eventually have another power conduit system coming in, probably to the side of this block, or maybe even phantom-faced to it, I'm not sure, that'll feed from here. And this generator will kick on at a lower percentage. So the long plan, the long-term goal is, the deep resonance generator will kick on at maybe 50% power, right? So this will kick on at 75%, and as long as the base is not using more energy than this is producing the oil generators, it'll fully run on oil power, right? But eventually, like say we turned on our quarry, right, and the oil generators can't keep up, it's going to drop below to 50, and then it'll kick on the deep resonance generator, which will produce a whole bunch of power for us. So that's kind of the plan. Let's get into deep resonance then, okay? So deep resonance is a cool mod. We're gonna get a deep resonance manual. Ta-da! There's a bunch of cool things that happen. Did I accidentally pick up? No, you're cool. Okay, good. Some stuff. Let's clean up our inventory. Boom, boom, boom. You go away. All these things can go away. That looks good. And you can go there for now. So deep resonance is a cool mod. It generates a large amount of power. And it's also one of those mods that's like fun to set up, and it generates a large amount of power for it. So there's a lot of manipulation and a lot of automation that we can build around this. And we'll probably get deep into some like crazy amounts of automation with it as time goes by. But to get started, we're going to get into the basics. The basics are that there's resonating ore in the world. And we've gotten some, courtesy of our quarries and our mining systems, right? 180 resonating ore that we have at the moment. Yay. That's going to be used as our power source. And we're going to generate crystals using that. You can sometimes find crystals deep underground, and thus far I've found 3, which is kind of nice. Do keep in mind that the crystals you find deep underground are usually pretty bad, and you don't want to use them to generate power. They're actually really bad, and you really don't want to use them to generate power. You can, but I wouldn't recommend it. Crystals all have attributes, and the attributes determine certain things about them. There's strength, which is basically, a long story short, it's the amount of power that a crystal has in total. So the total amount of power that you're going to get when you use this crystal to generate energy. Efficiency generates how much RF per tick you're going to get. So you might have like a billion RF in the crystal, let's say. I'm making up a number. And that's based on strength. And you might have, you know, 100 RF a tick, or 1,000 RF a tick, or 10,000 RF a tick. That's efficiency, right? Purity, that's an important one. What that is every time you use your crystals to generate power, it's going to create some negative effects in your environment. It's going to pollute the environment. And pollution is bad, as we can probably all know. Pollution will cause negative effects on your player, like hunger and some other debuffs as the pollution levels increase. And then it'll also start affecting the terrain, where the grass will also turn rotten, and a couple other bad things will happen. We're going to want to try and do our best to limit the amount of radiation that occurs. And yeah, that's going to be a goal. So we have to worry about all three of those stats. So keep those in mind as we start going through things. So let's start going through deep resonance and getting stuff set up. One of the first things we're going to want to get is a way to create these crystals, these resonating crystals. To do that, we need to smelt the resonating ore, right? So let's do this. There we go. So we've got resonating ore, and it's about 30 resonating ore is enough to make one crystal. So we're actually, like, we're enough to make 6 crystals right now, which is actually a lot. We should be really good. So to do this, one of the first things we're going to want to get is, I think we want some machine frames. So let's see. We need tanks. We need a smelter. And for this, we're going to need deep resonance machine frames. To get this, we're going to need resonating plates, which is actually pretty easy to get. You just smelt some resonating ore, and you get 8 of them. So, yeah, let's get some resonating ore. We'll get 4 of them for now, and we'll throw them into our alloy smeltery, and we'll throw this in there, put away this stuff that we don't need at the moment, and you're cool. Nice. So we've got 32 of these. So that's a good start. And we'll get a few machine frames. And then we will go and get ourselves the smelter. Cool. We're going to need some nether brick. So let's get nether. Let's get 30 of you. This will smelt rather quickly. So smelter, nether brick, 1, 2, 3. Cool. The other thing we're going to need is a tank. And for a tank, we're going to need some glass. Let's get a stack of that. And the way this is going to work is if we take a look at the smelter. Basically, you need a tank below filled with lava and a tank above, which will get filled with the liquid crystal when we start melting down these deep resonance crystals, okay? The problem or the trick is that the smelter works best when the lava tank is filled between 40 and 60% lava. So basically, if you're above 40 or below 60% lava in that tank, you're gonna get the best quality of crystal available. However, if you've got too much lava or too little lava, your crystal quality is gonna be bad, and we don't want that. So what I'm going to do is get an export bus. So craft me an exporter and get me a liquid monitor. That's a power monitor. I said liquid monitor or fluid monitor. There it is, this guy. Machine frame, gold. Nuggets. Let's make a few of these, because why not? Fluid monitor, check. Exporter, check. Tank, we're gonna want 2 of these. 1, 2, cool. And let's go set this up. I wanna build this in this general area up here. So like maybe like along this corner line here. And we'll probably compress this and make it more efficient in the future. But for now, we're just gonna get this up and running. Okay, so let's see how easily I can get this set up. We're gonna need a tank that's gonna sit here. And then we're gonna want the smelter on top of the tank, and we're gonna want a tank on top. And we're gonna come over down here, and we're gonna set this tank to have an exporter on it. And if you right click the side of the tank, you specify what mode the side is. So you can see on Whale it's telling you the mode is accept or provide or none. So make sure to do this, otherwise you won't be able to pipe liquids in there. Okay, we're gonna configure this guy, only work with a redstone signal, and then we're gonna run this cable. Like so. So now he's ready to export lava. And the good news is we have lava stored in our system. If we went home, and we went to, I do have a fluid monitor, don't I? I guess I never made one of those, did I? Let's make a fluid monitor. That'll be nice to have. A fluid grid, it's called. Fluid grid, yes. So I need an advanced processor, a grid, and a bucket. Okay, so a grid requires 2 improves and a destruction core. A machine casing. We're probably going to want to get our advanced going. And we're also going to want some quartz enriched iron. And then we can make our grid. Nice. And then we're going to want the advanced processor, which is done, and a bucket. Cool. And this will get us our fluid grid. So here's a cool thing with refined storage. Did you go away? You probably did. I'm going to pop this guy. He can sit up here. Hey, look! There's my lava. You want to see a neat trick? If you have buckets available inside the system, or if it knows how to autocraft them, when you just click on this, boom, you get a bucket's worth of lava. Haha, how cool is that? Nice? It used one of the buckets we had, and it got me a bucket of lava. So as we start adding more and more fluids to our refined storage system, this is totally going to be useful for us. So let's go down here, and I'm going to put the liquid monitor set up in such a way. Hopefully I can work this. We want the redstone signal to be facing up there. Can you see the tank? You totally can. So when a redstone signal should be sent, it's less than 40%. Let's make it like 45, okay? So when we're less than 45% lava in here, it's gonna emit a redstone signal, which it should be doing now. So all I have to do is tell it what kind of liquid to put in there. Put it in fluids mode and lava. And watch what happens. See the amount filling up? 5,000, 6,000, 7,000, 8,000, 9,000, stop. So it's stopped. We're probably right around 60%. What's 9,000 divided by 16,000? That is 56%. Nice. Let's make it like a little bit lower. Let's make it like 42. That should be good, right? So as we use lava, right? So let's say we had some buckets going on here. I'm going to get a couple. Scoop. Can I scoop buckets of lava out of here? Maybe I can't. Looks like I can't. Oh, well. We'll see as we use it that this is going to work. So the only other thing we're going to need here now is to take a nap. And then what we're going to need to do is give it RF. So in order for this lava to melt down the stuff, we need RF power. And we're also going to need some resonating ore. So let's get 30 of them, because remember, that's the amount that I said we're going to need to have. For now, let's just pop RF into this thing. You're serving a lot of tiles that I don't want you to serve. Serving 4 tiles now. Smelter. I don't like it. How much of a nuisance? Oh, that's going to be a big nuisance. Unless we put it underneath. We could put this underneath, right? And then we could pipe an energy conduit just straight up from there. Let's do that. Let's rearrange this a little bit. Can I put you to accept on the bottom there? Yes. Can I get this guy moved? I want to rotate this thing so that it's there. We'll put our exporter here. We will set you to requiring a redstone signal, fluids, lava. And then we'll just move this cabling. Dire wire, ho. You, like that. Cool. And then we can run conduits. So let's just do, conduits. Enhanced should be good. The only trick we'll be getting, let's make more of the green conduits. Can I just run cables right out of this thing? More than likely, right? Will you provide power? I don't know. Before I go running a crazy amount of wiring, let's just see. This thing currently has 7,000 power. If I just do this, will you get power? No. So we can't get power out of the phantom energy faces. That's still a thing. Cool. So now that we know that, we're going to probably want to tap into this power line. So let's run. And this is about to get super dire wiry. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to move. Let's turn this off. Make sure it's not going to export any liquid. I might put this here. This is what happens when you don't have enough room. We'll set you to the tank again, less than 42%, so that should be good. We'll put this back in here. And then if we've got, not done crafting yet. I might have enough, let's see. Nice. So you're getting power now? I still have an old conduit facade from somewhere. And now we've got juice going up here. And we'll probably need more power along the line anyway at some point soon. So that's good that that's there. Cool? Nice. All right, so you guys got the benefit of a super long episode today. But we're going to wrap up now. So what I'm going to do is put my resonating ore in here. And this is going to start smelting. And it's going to break this resonating ore down into a liquid. And it's using the liquid in the tank here. So we've got 8,800 millibuckets, right? And we just used another 200. In the tank, we can see all the attributes. Quality is an attribute I didn't talk about. Quality is only determined during this smelting process. If your tank is the right amount of lava, then you will get 100% quality. If it's the wrong amount of lava, if you have too little or too less, your quality will decrease, and that will affect how good your purity, strength, and efficiency can become. Okay, so make sure that you do this because it's really going to affect things later down the line. What we're going to do is wrap up the episode and we will come back next time and we're going to have a little bit more fun setting up some deep resonance. So you should be at 50% now, right? 8,000 of 16,000 is 50%. In a moment, we'll see this drop down to somewhere around 42% or whatever I set it to, right? 42%. All right. So it should be a couple more millibuckets, maybe one or two more smelting processes. And then if the lava starts filling back up, we'll know we've done a good job, right? I don't know what threshold in terms of millibuckets it's gonna be, but it should be soon. Like within the next millibucket or two, because it should be really soon. So we need 400, come on. So we need 200, you are gonna work, right? Don't make me a liar. Should have done the math on what millibucket percentage we're looking at, but 7,000. Our quality is still at 100%, so we're doing good. 6,800. I kind of want to take this out now because I'm getting a little nervous. Let me do math real quick. So 6,800 is 425%. So the next crafting operation should be the one to do it. So let's put one more in here and notice, oh, look, we just bumped up to 8,600. I was right there on the edge. Cool. So we're good. And we've got 100% quality here, which is also good. Cool. So I'll let this remaining amount drop down. We're going to fill up with the 30 resonating ores. So everything's working thus far, which is cool. Wrapping up point by far. Direwolf20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. We'll be back next time to do more automation around deep resonance, and hopefully by the end of next episode we have a deep resonance generator running so that I can give you guys a world download that has this thing all done. All right guys, take it easy.